So you want to become the wellness expert in your community, but do you know the wellness expert Trinity? Hi, I'm Dr. Lawrence Tam, and welcome to Wellness 2.0. This is episode number one. I call this episode the Wellness Expert Trinity. And the reason why I dedicated to do this on Wellness 2.0 is because Wellness 2.0, I believe, is about really creating wellness experts, changing you to become the trusted advisor in your community, the one, the go-to person that everybody wants to come to because they trust you, they know you, and they like you, and they refer to you. So you can actually really make an impact on the lives of the people in the community around you. That's my goal for Wellness 2.0. My goal is that to transform health and well-being of the world. And in order to do that, I can't do it alone, you can't do it alone, you need the help of everybody else. And I know my strengths and my skill set is actually in helping people create their lives to really transform themselves as the wellness expert. I know that you may be the well-renowned person or skilled at certain things in your particular line of work or in terms of health and well-being, so I'm here really to design these videos to help you translate that, take that out of your head and put it on paper or put it on a book, put it into a video or put it into a format at least for your community to really absorb your information, your genius and your talents and your expertise so they can get the message properly so that they actually will start to be inspired and be motivated to transform their life to become the person that they, you know, obviously should be, which is obviously heading towards the direction of health and well-being. In this episode, we're going to discuss how you become a wellness expert using the Wellness Expert Trinity, which is a three component of how you become a wellness expert or the trusted advisor or the go-to guy or girl in your community. Now, in this information overloaded age, is what I like to call it, because really you're bombarded with news, your Facebook, your Twitter, your emails, you're just overwhelmed by how much information is coming at you every single moment in your life, not just every day. Now, if you were your client, if you were your prospect, and you know, being a health practitioner, you're trying to give them advice on how you become healthier, but they're bombarded with all this information. How do they know to listen to you rather than all the other people around you? Well, there's a trick to that. You have to become the trusted advisor, which means that they have to trust, know, and like you in order for your message to actually get across to them that they're going to listen to you. And more importantly, refer you other people just like them for you to help them and sort out their life in terms of health. So that's what it means to become a wellness expert. And in order to do that, you actually have to be the interpreter because of all this information out there in the ethos of internet and Google, people have varying opinions. And how do they know who to listen to? Well, you need to be that expert, that person, the trusted advisor to sift through that information and become the interpreter or the translator of all that information and make it relevant to them. And in order for you to do that, become the wellness expert, you have to have what I call the Wellness Expert Trinity. Well, Wellness Expert Trinity is made up of three components. And I call it a trinity because they all kind of go hand in hand. It's sort of like the body, mind, spirit. It's not, they're three different things, but they have to work together as one to make, you know, you, for example. So the first component of the trinity is the persona. What I mean by persona is that you are unique. Right? You are different than I am. You have this unique ability and you have your unique experience that made you who you are today. That uniqueness is what distinguishes you from everybody else around you, even your competitors that are around you and all the other health experts that's you know, in effect out there in the ethos of internet. So here's the thing. Your persona is your personality. It could be a physical characteristic, an emotional characteristic, or it could be your knowledge characteristic or your trait or your talent. See, we all have hidden talents, and that's what we want to, you know, really provide. Now, let me give you an example of this. You know, when you look in a newspaper and you actually see these cartoons on politicians or, you know, other famous people, and what they do is they take these people, right, these famous people, say Obama, for example, and they will blow out the physical characteristics that is you know, really relevant to where a viewer from another world could look and go, oh, I know that's Obama. And you can actually be able to distinguish that as Obama because of that physical characteristic. And it might be his ears, for example. Or, you know, in Australia, it would be, you know, Julia Gillard. It might be her nose or her haircut. And those are the distinguished features that really these cartoonists make out so that you know who they are based on those physical characteristics. Well, it's sort of like this when you really have a persona about you at being an expert. You take those physical characteristics or your mental characteristics or your unique skills that you have about you and you blow them out of proportion so that people recognize that, oh, that's you. That's that Lawrence Tam guy for Mullins 2.0. That's how you want to create a brand about yourself and really people for you and your community to know you as the wellness expert. Persona could be anything. It could be your ability, your skills. You might be very skillful in the way you speak. You might be very skillful in the way you write. Or it may just be your story, your background. You might have born in, say, like Tony Robbins. He was born in a poverty-stricken type of family. He lived in a very small apartment. He lived in a hammock or in a bathtub for the first few months of his life when he was out on his own at a very young age. So those are the story that attracts people to you that will always remember you by. That's the persona that you want to have about you. You want to create a persona become being the wellness expert so you're instantly recognized so that people know you and remember you. The second part of the trinity is what I call preparation. Preparation is basically your ability to accumulate information over the years. Now you've been to lots of university, you've been to a lot of seminars, you read a lot of books on a variety of different topics through your lifetime. I'm sure you have because you wouldn't become a health expert or health professional without doing so. Now, with all those books and all those topics, you're going to have a variety of different passions and in different areas of your life. You need to go through that and say, those are what makes up who you are. And you'll be reading different books than everybody else. And those accumulations of those education in those areas are what makes you different as a wellness expert because you're going to have accumulation of different expertise that no one else has. And that adding to that with your persona will create that third component. The third component of the trinity is the production value. The production value is basically how you're going to be able to produce, combining your own unique talent, adding to that your unique preparation or unique knowledge, adding to that how you're going to be able to translate that message to your prospects and your clients so they can understand clearly on the message you're trying to deliver. Now, it may be in a format of a video, just like you're watching this video. It may be in a format of an audio. It might be, say, an MP3 or a podcast. And like what I have done in creating the Wellness Guys along with Dr. Damien Kristoff and Dr. Brett Hill. We created a weekly show on podcast on health and wellness that has now become number one in the health industry and the health podcast in Australia. That would be an example of a production that people can sort of get information from us. Now, it could maybe from a blog. You might be a great writer. You might be able to write a book like Dr. Brett Hill has, and he's written a book on called How to Eat an Elephant. And that book, because he's such a great writer, that's his unique skill. For me, I can't write at all. So therefore, I do videos because I'm much more comfortable with standing in front of a camera and actually just talking to a camera rather than talking to you directly on video rather than writing a story or writing a book or writing chapters on my health expertise. So Dr. Damien Kristoff is a little bit different story, right? He's a great presenter. He knows how to communicate with people and he can speak off the cuff without any scripting. And by doing so, one of his production lines was that he has his own television show called Downsize Me that ran for a couple of years. And that was his strength. He was able to take his talent, his particular knowledge with being a naturopath and a chiropractor, and the knowledge of that really created a persona. Adding to that with the persona of him being Damien Kristoff, he had some unique abilities to really create a television show that people remember and knows him. And if whenever he goes to New Zealand, he is famous and people know and recognize him based on that. So those are the three components of the wellness expert trinity. Number one, you have your persona, which is your unique skills or your experience or the uniqueness about you. Number two, your preparation, which is all the skills and expertise that you've gathered through your reading and your attending the seminars and your studies. And number three is your production line, whether it be through video, radio, podcasts, books, whatever format you might want to produce your products to be so that people get your information so they can actually make a wise decision on listening to you as the wellness expert. So what are your next steps then? Now, first, I'm going to give you three steps. Number one, you need to figure out what persona you want to emulate. You want to, because you don't want to become like anybody else. You don't want to follow and be like anybody else. You want to be you because you're unique. You have this ability about you and you have a strength and talent about you. You got to just hone in and figure what that is. And you got to dig deep to find that out. Here's an advice for you is to ask other people around you, your best friends, the people, your partners who know you better than you do, because they're going to ones who know that you have this unique talent that you may not have figured out yet. So that's number one. Number two is that you're going to go through all the seminars and all the books and all the years of study that you've gone through and find out what you're actually passionate about. It may be on topic of, say, losing weight, and you're really good at understanding that market. And then you might be another market might be on exercise. And those are two separate areas and two separate area of focus. So we're going to talk about that in later episodes on how you target your market. So if you can figure out what those preparations are and your passions are, then you can figure out how you're going to be able to deliver your wellness expertise. Number three is your production line. How can you produce quality videos or audios, podcasts, books, or ebooks or blogs that will get the message across? Whatever it takes to get your message out there into the community so people understand you and actually be able to consume the information and then say, wow, you are the expert. You're the trusted advisor that I want to come to see you. And you know what? If you can help me, then I'm going to tell and refer other friends and all my family to see you because you become the trusted advisor in that community. Now, why is it so important? Well, think about this. This is the goal of Wellness 2.0. I want to help you create, I want to create wellness experts across the world. Because at the end of the day, I can't change the world based on teaching people health. You can't change the world teaching people, your prospects or your clients about health alone. We need all of us to work together. We need health professionals, people with this unique skills and unique knowledge and unique experience combined all across the world and in their own communities really tries to start to change the health of the nation, really, or health of their community. And by doing so, everybody around the world is going to be able to help create a healthier world for the next generation. And I believe that that's the best leverage that we can do, and we need to start from the ground up. So this is the point of Wellness 2.0, and this is the point for you to get you to become the wellness expert. So now, what you got to do right now is, well, you got to leave a comment below. Let me know what you think of this episode. Let me know what you think of the Trinity. Let me know what you have been doing, what you're going to do to ensure that you're going to have become the wellness expert using these three concepts. I'm Dr. Lawrence, and welcome to Wellness 2.0.